Oh yeah. Carson seems to be on fire in the last 10 minutes. This is the second fish on in the last 10 minutes.
Welcome to Great Lakes Hunting and Fishing. I'm Brandon Clark and this is Carson Whitley. Here we're out here on Elk Lake in Elk Rapids, Michigan, fishing for whitefish.
These whitefish to come into our shanty, we need to chum them in. So we got a chumming can, you fill it with whitefish eggs right here, and we're gonna stick it down to the bottom and open the can. Right now we're in 25 feet of water roughly, so we're on a slow gradual bank that the whitefish travel up for, looking for food. So this is our chum. It's got whitefish skein in it that's from the summer. We get it from a local fishery that sells fish meat. So yeah, that smells like ash. So that's how that goes. You stick that lid on top and clip that to that and send her down the hole.
Why don't you tell us a little bit about why you use eggs instead of corn? I know corn's a popular method.
So most people use corn because corn is easy to come by in the stores. You just get canned corn and put it down the hole. Whitefish cannot digest corn, so it can slowly kill the fish if they don't eat natural eggs or anything. They can't digest it. It binds them up and they won't bite as long. That's why we use fish eggs. That's how you're supposed to.
And they'll die from the corn. It'll kill them.
You get to the bottom.
We're fishing with our good buddy Hayden Dvorak. We want to take a minute to tell you about the chum. The chum is definitely a key to getting these whitefish in here, because the chum on the bottom, they can smell it and then they find it. And they come in and feed on it, and they just keep coming back, and more of them find it. And so you got to make sure you have chum down, so you always got some food for them to eat, so they can kind of stick around here, and they know where the food's at, so when we're here, they're around to catch them. And
we've had our chum down for a couple weeks now, getting them baited all in pretty much. It's pretty much just like deer baiting, but with fish. But it's been about 3 weeks with solid ice, maybe even a month. So what we got here is a medium heavy rod. It is pretty flexible. I mean, it's gonna be good for whitefish because they do put up quite a bit of a fight. All you need to set it up is gonna be a treble hook. Smaller the better, size 10 or less. Slip sinker and a swivel with some 4 pound leader between your hook and your swivel.
Forgotten words. I never got the same.
Well, we're all set up in the shanty, just getting ready to put our lines down in the water. We got the heaters on, the liners on.
What we got here is just some prepared, they're salmon eggs, they're for trout fishing. Just one on every treble with the hook just barely sticking out of the egg. Drop to the bottom and put on your bobber. So, just send it down and get the bobber ready. Just use a cedar shave bobber here, homemade. Those seem to work the best. So now that we're on bottom, just get the bobber on here. Slip it on. And we're ready to fish. You'll see it go down and you set the hook.
All right, well, we've been fishing for about half an hour now, and we've had maybe 20 or so bites, but they just haven't been there. Sometimes when the fish are coming in, they'll hit your line, and that'll make your bobber go underwater and can trick you and make you think it's a bite. It's not necessarily a bite, but we did hook into one fish already, and it popped off about halfway up. So we're gonna keep trying and hopefully get a couple fish on the ice. Oh, you missed them. The hook set on these fish are it's a very important thing, because if you don't set the hook hard enough, sometimes you won't get up to where they're at, or... Oh, it was a fish.
Yeah, boy, that's a fish.
Yeah,
that was a slow boat to China, that
bite. This has got to be in its mouth.
For sure.
It was there after it was underwater.
Looks like it's a nice fish.
Is it?
Well, I'm just saying from the way it's acting.
Oh, I can't see it.
I don't have color yet, but kind of bad.
These whitefish like to put up a heck of a fight. They do pretty well. It's got
here
some,
he comes. Oh, some, nice one.
Is it? One second. He's running.
It's a nice whitey too.
Jeez, he's just peeling line.
He saw the hole and said, no, thank you. I'm not going there.
Let me get him up into the net. I'll pull him up in the hole. Looks like he might have to go from this. Yeah, he spins around. He must face him that way.
Oh, here he comes. Here he comes.
He might run again. We'll see. Fish in the net. Alright, good job. Awesome. Hooks out. All right, 1 second. Jeez. There's our first white fish of the night. Here we go.
Right there, nice white fish.
White fish of the night. It's a pretty nice one. It's not huge, but it's pretty thick. It'll be a good eater. So we're gonna put her barrier in the snow so she doesn't freeze. And keep fishing, catch some more. When the bites are slow, we got our kettle cooked
sea salt and vinegar chips to snack on. And our Gatorade. Watching the bobbers. Get kind of boring when there's no action. But I spent about 15 minutes without a bite right now. Carson seems to be on fire in the last 10 minutes. This is the second fish on in the last 10 minutes.
Wants to run, let him run if he comes up the hole. There he is, he called it.
Wait.
Head first,
right there.
Nice.
Head first.
Nice whitefish here, this is my second one tonight. Nice chubby thick one we got here. Seemed to be really good tonight. The bite's good.
Yeah, but it never run.
Oh yeah. Oh, it's off.
Yeah.
If you were gonna do that.
He's talking about moving, he's just saying that.
Oh yeah. Fish on. That reel is so shitty.
You sure?
Hayden.
You want me to give the camera to Hayden?
No, I want to stay right there. That reel is a piece of shit. The Kmart where?
The Kmart special.
$14.99.
You don't need anything special. I mean, a rod and a reel, and that's all you need.
Oh, it's off.
Ended up with three really nice whitefish here tonight. Lost probably four or five. Had a nice night in the shanty. It's 9:30. The bite started to slow down, so we're probably going to call her a night.
This is the best night we've had so far this year, so we can't complain. Here on Elk Lake in Elk Rapids, Michigan. We'll catch you next time on Great Lakes Hunting and Fishing.